Glory to Jesus. You know, some time ago, I did a reflection on this text about who is my mother, my brother, and my sister, like Jesus talked about. When I was looking at it again this morning, I saw it in another light. Something I've never really seen before. I looked at this reading so many times this morning, and I realized Jesus' own personality. And I noticed too that the way you approach people elicits their characteristic response to you. And their response would usually be all they are made of their stuff. That is what says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So when you approach people, and depends on how you approach them, that's how they will react to you. They will bring out their own character. You see their quality. So when you react to someone who is mad, for instance, you get madness. If you approach someone who is humble, you get humility. If you approach someone who is gentle, you would get gentility. If you approach a teacher, you get lessons. So today, this man approached Jesus. It's not just that he approached him, but the manner in which he was approached. Now, I want us to look at it in other aspects. This is the Jesus that his family has been looking for. This is the Jesus that everybody was concerned about in his family. In fact, if you read St. Mark's Gospel, chapter 3, verses 20 and 21, you see a similar situation. It is possible they are reporting this, but that is Mark's own version. You see, it's chapter 3, St. Mark's Gospel. And they went to a house. And the crowd gathered again, together again, so much that they were not even able to eat bread. And when his own family heard of it, they went out to take hold of him, for they said, he has gone mad. Some scriptures, text of scripture will tell you, he has gone out of himself. They felt that Jesus was not crazy, that he wouldn't even eat, that he was spending all his time with people. You get home, people always moving around about him. So they wanted to get him, they wanted to move him, get him out. And again, we say, it's the same crowd that is with Jesus today. The same crowd. It was why he was still speaking that this man came. You know, when Jesus was approached, he would usually respond. Right from when he was a child. When Joseph and Mary were looking for him, and everybody saw him, Mary said, son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you everywhere. He said, why were you looking for me? Didn't you know that you find me in my father's house? That's how he responds. He will teach you a lesson. He will talk to you. When the disciples, if you go to St. John's Gospel, chapter 4, when they went to buy bread, the man was talking to the woman at the well. After he has dispatched him, he said, Rabbi, come and eat. Rabbi, come and eat. He says, no. I have food to eat. They were wondering, has somebody brought him food? He said to them, my food is to do the will of my father. That's what he does. He was give a lesson out of every situation. You don't pressurize Jesus. You don't run into him and want to force him to do things that he doesn't want to do. Even before Pontius Pilate, you couldn't force him. Force him to speak, he didn't say anything. When they said to him, do you know I have the power to release you? He looked at him and said, you wouldn't have that power if God didn't give it to you. That's how Jesus is. He would teach. Now today, he was with the crowd. The word of God tells us, while he was still speaking, what was he talking about? The lesson was given them is about an unclean spirit leaves a man, he goes about what other space and goes everywhere, looking for where to stay. Doesn't find, he comes back to the heart, finds his where so goes out and brings seven more deadly spirits and reside in that heart. That's what he was telling them. The scripture says, while he was still speaking, somebody says, your mother and your brother are looking for you. While he was still speaking, hey. You don't do that even to me while I'm still talking. I will lash you back. What is the emergency about? Why can't they wait? Do you imagine that if the person had come to Jesus and said to Jesus, whispered in his ears, your mother is looking for you, your brother, he wouldn't respond this way. But so the person intruded. He was still teaching. He was still giving his lessons to the people. He says, While Jesus was speaking to the people, why was he speaking? A man, an unidentified man, is there anybody that should just talk to Jesus? Don't you have disciples? Close people. Peter is there, James and John are there. Why didn't he say, Peter, approach him? Why don't they meet Peter and James? You want to do that? You want to bounce into my office? You come to my office with that, my leg, I should go back. Then secretary there, tell the secretary you want to see me. Your mother is looking for you, your brother is looking for you. They interrupted him. And then he taught them a lesson. Who are my mother? Who are my brother? This do the will of God. Come to think about it, Mary did the will of God. So there was never any way Jesus was speaking against Mary. No way. So look at how he was approached, how he was interrupted. He was teaching a great lesson, letting of vital importance. Because at the end, he says, that is what is going to happen to this generation. He was talking about a lesson very, very important. And the man just said, your mother, your brother, your mother, they are looking for you. Interrupted him. And then, in his usual way, he gave them a lesson. Who are my mother, my brother, my sister? Listen, what I'm saying is very important. Nobody, you know, in Nigerian language, say, now mother, they talk now. And they tell you so and say, my mother, do the will of God, you'll be my mother. No, no, in Nigeria, that's how you say in Nigerian language. That's not the thing that happened here. So how do you approach people? When you have something, even serious to say, how do you approach people? Some persons don't know how to approach people. You know, they don't know how to approach people. Someone dies when someone tells somebody. You don't just come and say, your pinky don't die. Do you say that? Don't say that. Somebody, your mother don't die. Your brother don't die. No, you have to look at the situation, calm down, and say, I don't know, are you alone at home? They say, what? I say, no, I just want to help you to you. Then you go gather people, you know, then we start. You tell, some people don't even know about their children's death. Years after, I know of a priest whose aunt lost the daughter. They were still buying clothes and giving to the woman and say, your daughter is not. She never knew that she lost that daughter. Because if you tell her, she probably will die. So you manage people. So you don't just intrude, intercept people, just people are doing something serious, you just come and intrude and just distract them. If you distract some people, they'll give you back.